ready.
Oh, you.
Well. Drop. Next one. Ready? Yeah. Oh. Yeah. Thank you.
Instagram.
Fuck. Legs like jelly, man.
Fuck squats.
Fuck squats. Third exercise for quads is going to be heel elevated squats. Using little platform I've made, obviously going to increase flexibility at the knee, allow you to get a bit deeper, and close stance is going to put more emphasis on the quad over a wide squat, which will bring in more glute through the movement. Two sets of this, basically to failure, just because I haven't got the load to get to a 5-9 set. So just pure failure. Thank you. Last exercise for quads is going to be a heel elevated banded dumbbell wall squat, basically a hack squat, using the foam roller just to get a smooth range of motion. And with squat movements at the moment, I'm not really working in any kind of set range just because I don't have enough weight to constantly just hit 5 to 9 for every movement. So I'm basically just doing what I can to failure and just working off that weight and just trying to increase the reps every week. That's what I'm doing for squats, as well as exercise order. Normally I'd do my compounds first, just because they're the mechanical tension based sets. Your 5 to 9s are going to be the main driving factor of hypertrophy, but purely for the fact I can't hit the 5 to 9s on most of my squatting movements, I've been doing my isolation exercises first. That's why I did leg extension first, just to try to fatigue the muscle as much as I can to make my squatting movements as hard as I can. Regarding everything else though, so pull and push, compound still going first. I was in effect to pull my hook down.
Leave that in.
Straighten up the roller.
Yeah.
Fuck. Shit fucking burns. You
done. I'm done. Hey, hello.